Well, ladies and gentlemen, it's Wargames! WWE Survivor Series Wargames! And oh, I just watched it, and oh my god, I can't believe what happened! And so I'm gonna go for every single match here that happened on WWE Wargames, starting off with the women's Wargames match. And oh my god, you talk about match of the night when it comes to women. Oh my god, yeah. Holy, the advantage went to Team Becky because you guys voted for Team Becky to have the advantage. It was unbelievable. Team Bianca, I should say, had the advantage. Not Team Becky, but it doesn't matter. It was a great match. There were so many spots. There was a chain. There was kendo sticks. There was tables. Trash cans. Trash can lids. Irie Zane used that freaking trash can lid like she was Captain America. Bam! Bam! It was epic. Loads of good spots, I'm not gonna lie, I absolutely loved it. I really did love the first opening match. And there was even a spot where, I think it was EEO Sky, climbed the top of the freaking cage, putting the chain down to Dakota Kai, who was at ringside. Dakota Kai from underneath the, out of nowhere, got a trash can lid from underneath the ring, and she then fished it up like it was a freaking anchor. She climbed on top of it. She put the trash can lid over her, jumped on the entire Team Bianca. Oh my god, I thought that should have been it. Asuka was the last woman into the match for War Games to begin, and that was just wild. But after everything, Bayley deserves a round of applause, so she sacrificed herself. She got speared by Charlotte Flair. She got taken out by Shotzi. She got taken out by the Anchor Battle with the KOD. And then got put through the table by Becky Lynch with a manhandle slam through the table. 1, 2, 3. Team Bianca Belair with the victory. Then up next was the Intercontinental Championship match, as the Intercontinental Champion Gunther went one-on-one with The Miz, and it was a slow, there wasn't much to it. Gunther did Gunther things. Miz tried his best to injure Gunther's legs, but in the end, it was a submission. Even after hitting the powerbomb, Miz kicked out. Hitting those chops, Miz kicked out. You know, but it was a busting crab type, like a Wars of Jericho, like a maneuver from Gunther, making the Miz tap out. And still, the Intercontinental Champion, Gunther! Then, of course, we had Dragon Lee versus Santos Escobar. I was sidetracked. It wasn't that interesting of a match. Santos Escobar won, obviously. It was okay, I'm not gonna lie. Then we got to the Women's World Championship match, as Mami defends her title against Zoe Stark. And my god, that was a really good match. There wasn't even a point where I thought that Zoe Stark was gonna do it. I thought that Zoe Stark was gonna hit the C360. Nah, she got caught, then got turned into a headbutt, into a riptide. 1, 2, 3. Rhea Ripley retains the World Heavyweight Championship, or the Women's World Heavyweight Championship, and because Mami is always on top. Nothing happened after that match, as we then went on to the main event. It was the men's War Games match, as Team Cody Rhodes took on the team of the Judgement Day, JD McDonagh, Dominic Mysterio, Damian Priest, and Finn Balor, teaming up with Drew McIntyre. And that was a hell of a banger of a match. Table spot where the half pretty much when Damian Priest basically took out and the entire Judgement Day took out everyone. Now, throughout Survivor Series, the build-up was this. Is Randy Orton going to make it? Is he going to be able to show up? Well, we'll see a Punk return. I was like, nah, he ain't going to return. There's too much heat. There's too much heat down here this man has. So, it comes to the point where Damian Priest is battered and bruised. He almost did what I thought he was going to do. He put Seth Rollins through a table. But then a countdown gets to zero, and we were expecting to hear voices, the theme voices, but nada! We hear Rhea Ripley coming down the ring with the referee on tow with the Money in the Bank briefcase and saying that Damian Priest is cashing in. He's cashing in. And just as the referee's like, okay, and Damian Priest is about to cash in. What do we hear? I hear the voices in my head like, Randy Orton is back! And he's returned from his back injuries, and he went in that freaking cage, the Wargames cage, and he kicked all kinds of ass! Power slam to Dominic Mysterio, power slam to JD McDonough, hitting the DDT to Finn Balor! Oh my god, and that was man. He even got to the other side of the ring, staring him down was Drew McIntyre. We know the history between those two men. It was unbelievable. The crowd were going wild, chanting Randy Orton's name, and I'm thinking, thank god they've come from CM Punk to Randy Orton. They are, we're like, okay, we know that CM Punk's not gonna return. Let's chant for Randy. Let's get this warm feeling, fuzzy feeling out of our tum-tums, as Simon Miller would say. That's it. DDT's for everybody. And then that was it. That was it was an RKO party pretty much for everybody. It was then time as everyone was getting beaten down. JD McDonagh was getting up. He was like, no way, fuck this, I'm going to try and escape the top of the cage, I'd rather live for another day. Yeah, it means forfeit in for Judgement Day, but fuck it, I'm getting out of there. But nada! Cody Rhodes, I think it was Cody Rhodes, no, Sami Zayn, I believe, because I remember that everyone hit their finishes for everybody. Sami Zayn took out Drew McIntyre with the Helluva kick, we saw Jey Uso super kick. So I hit the splash to him afterwards. That got rid of him. We saw Seth Rollins hit the stomp to Finn Balor or Damian Priest on to the outside. That was it pretty much. And then of course because of that reason he had no one to run. He Jey Uso and Sami Zayn was like, nah, you ain't going nowhere. And of course they climbed up after him, beat him down, and Randy Orton looked up and he went, oh yeah, this is gonna be good. They pushed JD Madonna down into Randy Orton, BAM! RKO! And he said, you know what, Cody? You got this! As he was about, he got picked up, Damian Priest pushed him into Cody Rhodes. Cody Rhodes, your main man, hits the crossroads. 1, 2, 3. The winners are Team Cody Rhodes. Everyone, the replays happen. Everyone's celebrating in the ring. And just when I thought everything was over, it was CM Punk! I cannot believe he's back! The one guy at Germany didn't want to see come back after everything that he's done. How? Did they give him a big wad of cash and say, hey, come back in Chicago, here you go. One is good. I thought it was a one and done moment, but before I did this recording, I looked on WWE.com to see if it was a one and done. Ah, another! He's back! He is back for good. He is back on the roster. Where is he going to go? Is he going to go to Raw? I believe so. And the Judgment Day are all the ones that are on Raw. Randy Orton's back. CM Punk is back. What is going to happen with CM Punk? I'm going to watch Raw to find out. I don't know how I feel, no pun intended, about CM Punk being back. And what am I going to do about CM Punk? I don't know. I genuinely fucking don't know what's going to happen. But hey! We'll have to find out as the next pay-per-view, I believe, is TLC, but I don't think so. I think it might be the Royal Rumble, because they did the advertisements for it. So, but let me know! I'm going to give 2 thumbs up, and to be honest, I don't know, due to my mixed emotions, I'm going to give it 4.5 stars out of 5, because CM Punk's back, and we had that lackluster of a match between Santos Escobar and Dragon Lee. So, with that being said, I'm Dan, 2x15 on Xbox Live, and I want you to let me know what you thought of Survivor Series, and we'll see you at WWE Royal Rumble predictions. Until then, goodbye. Thank you very much for watching this video. If you enjoyed this video, then feel free to subscribe. If you want to watch the previous video, then click on the video on the left. But if you want to watch the playlist, then click on the playlist that's on the right.